I will now show you how easy it is to perform a 3D visualization of the laser output with Pangolin BEYOND and the 3D visualization software Realizzer 3D from within BEYOND. For that, a BEYOND license, as also a 3D Realizzer license, will be needed for the last, at least the professional license. Here on the website of Realizzer 3D at www.realizzer.com, you can see the different features of the various licenses. The function of the Pangolin laser inputs is important here. Now we change over to Realizzer 3D and open an empty room. In this empty room, we now add a generic RGB laser projector from the library at Fixtures, Laser, Generic. We move it a little bit up and then click on Rotate to rotate the laser output towards us. The red line indicates where the front of the laser is and in which direction the output is output. Then we ensure that the laser projector is selected at the object list and that it is enabled at the DMX patching. Now we scroll a little bit further down and convince us that the active checkbox is selected and the laser source in this case is set to 1. This corresponds to the fixture number of the projection zone in BEYOND that we will discuss later. Now we change over to BEYOND and activate here at View the advanced visualization by an external software. A window opens to confirm that step and we click on Yes. Ultimately, we activate the button Show it now and then start the playback. We now return to Realizzer and as you can see here, the laser output is displayed here. I quickly change to the live mode and for an optimized output, I open the visual settings, reduce the overall brightness, increase the fog output and get such a clearly visible representation. In the 3D window, I can move around in the room in 3D. As promised, let's come back to the relationship between the laser source and the BEYOND projection zones. To do this, we add a few more laser projectors here. We duplicate a laser projector by holding down the control key and then move the new laser projector over to this point. In the properties of the object, we must now even patch it and alter the direction of the laser output. We do the same with the other one here. Patching this one and assign the laser source number 2 to these two here now. As you can see, they have no output anymore. Therefore, we switch to BEYOND and send the laser output to a corresponding projection zone there now. At first, we pause the output. First of all, we assign a fixed projection zone to the event tracks. Here, for example, we assign the projection zone Main Graphics to this track. For the other two tracks, we assign the projection zone Scanner to Main. At the settings, projection zone settings, we navigate to the projection zone Scanner to Main that we have just assigned to the two tracks too. Then we change to the tab Extended and down here at the settings for external visualization, we now see the assignment to fixture number 2 that corresponds to the laser source allocation in Realizzer 3D. Default is 1, but we want to have a visualization of the laser source 2 for this projection zone. Then we restart the playback in BEYOND. I fast forward to a point at which a laser output also appears in the projection zone 2, so scanner 2 main. Then I switch back to Realizzer. As you can see, you get an output now for the two newly added laser projectors for the projection zone scanner 2 main only, while the first added laser projector only performed the output of the first projection zone.